Valco.
Serves you right.
I've prepared something.
Can she just stop that?
Don't forget our brilliant...
From booze to biscuits.
Red Hot Dales.
Loads of two-for-ones.
The finest butchers, the freshest meat.
Friendly staff, always happy to help.
Am I getting paid for this?
Don't forget the Valco tick.
Everyone always gets it wrong, it's definitely that way.
Tick.
Serves you right.
Valco serves you right.
Now with added pleasure foods.
Oh, dear. I don't know why I let you talk me into doing that.
Oh, that was so much fun, though, wasn't it?
I'll tell you, if head office saw me doing that, they'd drag me over the coals, but yes, it was fun.
You see, you love it when we do new stuff.
Cheryl Fairweather, you should be in aisle 9 with the rest of the souls.
Right, well, I better hit the road.
Already? Oh, no, I can't go another week without you.
Oh, yes, you can. Now, come on, we both knew this long-distance relationship would be tough, but look at it this way. A week apart will give you time to get your strength back after yesterday.
God, Cheryl, people could hear.
No, let them.
And how many times should you take it?
Four.
Before or after meals?
Before.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Go on, then, you're ready.
Two fat ladies, four.
10 5E, what do I get for 10 5E?
That says lose.
Oh! Hey, there were a woman on local news and she won £10,000, but she lost a card.
So what happened next?
The weather, the one show, one they had a man on who could see into the past. Right, another one. Oh, can I have a new coin, please, Brian?
Margaret, you don't need a new coin for every... Oh, all right, then, here you go.
Oh, a cat! Oh, no. Oh, Alan hates cats.
You haven't won a cat.
How come you're in before Neville? Don't you get the bus in together?
Not anymore. Can't send him singing to me.
Why, what does he sing?
Linda, Linda, I love you, even when you make me blue.
Oh, yeah, that'd get my tits too.
Yes, now I take the bus and he walks. It's only 6 miles and he likes exercise.
Ooh.
There she is. Linda, Linda, I love you, even when you make
Keep
me
blue. Keep walking!
Right you are.
CD player? Are you from the 90s?
Had to confiscate it from the bakers. A customer complained, said they caught them listening to porn.
Listening to porn?
Listening.
Filthy Girls of Rotterdam. Listeners' Wives. Adele.
They just really like Adele. Well, anyway, can you pop that in the office, please?
Sure. Sorry, I didn't get you anything.
Well, don't worry, you'll have to give me something later then, won't you?
God, that feels sexy.
Yeah? What else would you like me to give you?
Egg and chips.
Well, you kind of ruined the moment a bit there, but bring it back.
You love my dippy egg.
Oh, I love your dippy egg. I'm a chip. And oh, Neville. Slicer, knackered again. Could you just come and have a quick look?
Ah, it's actually broken this time.
Yeah.
You're not just trying to trap my time.
Yes!
Don't get me wrong, I love this workplace banter. It's just, this is the fifth time this month, so please let me out.
Yeah, but if I let you out, Neville, you won't learn your lesson, will you? So I'm doing this for your own good, innit?
You are so immature sometimes.
Thank you. I really appreciate it.
Oh! Home strike! Innit? Wow. See you later.
Oh, man.
Ooh, CDs. Anything good?
Not really your thing.
I don't know. You'd be surprised what I'm into. Hell's teeth. Absolutely not.
Bakers. Mm. So, how was your weekend with the lovely Cheryl?
Oh, well, it was great. I'm exhausted. We had a 20-mile bike ride on Sunday and then some, kind of fair amount of other physical activities, if you catch my drift.
Ew.
I'm sorry, Daniel. I've absolutely no idea where that filth came from.
What's the fact?
Well, it's a ridiculous message from our glorious interim leader. So, look, the Christmas period was so successful, let's try and make every period that successful. I mean, the man's an idiot.
So, no news on the new area manager, then?
No, nothing. It's all pretty slim pickings out there.
What about Keith from Stockport?
Keith Forrest? I mean, he's good branch, but he's not area.
Roxanne Lane?
No, branch.
Marcus Ford?
Branch.
And Nathan Pease?
It's branch.
Fast, effective and non-evasive. That's like my sex life.
Nice front of house. Is it still policy to have catalogue models on customer services?
As if anyone's stupid enough to go for lines like that.
Wait, you think I look like a model? Sharp. Do you? No way. Do you?
Of course you're stupid enough.
Duncan Trench, new rep from Pleasure Foods. Single and ready to mingle. Here to see Gavin Strong.
Here,
have a card. Give the boss man a bell, will you, love? While I'm here, do you do returns? Because you've taken this guy's breath away. Bit of retail-based flirting.
Gavin, there's a moron down here to see you.
Shut up!
Honestly, you could do music videos. Though, if you came on the screen at my gym, I'd drop the weights. All 130K. It's what I bench.
Stop it.
Yeah, please stop it.
Can I help you?
Ah, Duncan Trench, Pleasure Foods. Delighted to be your new sales rep. Here, have a card.
Ah, right, so thank you. Oh, yes, Duncan Trench. Putting the sales into sales rep. I'm pretty sure that makes sense.
It's genius, eh? Have you noticed anything about the size?
Oh, yes, very large, isn't it? Doesn't quite fit into my wallet.
Exactly. Stands out. Memorable.
Yeah, right. Now, listen, the thing is that we normally deal with Gentle Ben from Pleasure Foods. Is he on holiday?
Yeah, very long one. Dead. Car, bus, good night. Still, every cloud, eh? Meet your new superior sales rep.
Gentle Ben is dead? I think I need to sit down. I think I might lean, if you don't mind.
Oh! Oh, I've won £10! Oh, Brian, I've never won £10 before.
Yeah, don't get too excited. I mean, look how many you've played. There must be 50-odd there. £10 won't cover it. It's a mug's game.
Don't be silly. These are free.
What?
Well, scratch cards. They don't cost money.
Margaret, where did you get the cards?
Well, they were on the kiosk, and I thought, oh, they look like a bit of fun. And then I thought, I wonder if Alan will notice if I only put half the mince in the shepherd's pie tonight.
Forget about the shepherd's pie.
Sorry, it's all I can think of now.
Look, Margaret, these cards cost £2 each. I mean, how many have you played?
60.
That's 120, well, minus the 10 you've won. You owe the kiosk till £110.
Oh, that's nearly £100.
Any chance of Pleasure Foods getting some more shelf space?
Oh, no, you've got your allocated shelving.
Yeah, that could be your answer. Or you could say yes and be the proud owner of a brand new second-hand Audi.
Are you trying to bribe me?
No, I'm joking. Unless you want a bribe, do you want a bribe? No, I'm joking.
No, the humour's a very important part of retail, but I think making a joke about shelf space is very close to the knuckle.
Well, here's the plan. You and me, tour of the store. You're the lion. Show me your jungle.
Unfortunately, this lion has a smaller pride, lions and tigers. I've got a lot on, is what I'm trying to say.
Absolutely. I'll look around on my own. You won't even know I'm here. Duncan Trench, Pleasure Foods. Duncan Trench, Pleasure Foods.
Oh, can I have a card?
No. Mind if I join you? Lovely Linda.
No, this is my boyfriend, Neville.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Seems nice.
Gavin!
Oh, big leg.
I see he's still keeping you on here, you toe rag.
Well, they're not five me yet, touch wood. How's Jean?
Well, jealous of all the calls I'm getting from Kate Moss, begging me to run away with her.
Oh, you know, we've been doing this banter for years, and, oh, big Len, it's as funny now as it was then. Great stuff.
Chocolate fizz, what's that?
Oh, it's a fizzy chocolate-flavoured juice. Seems very popular.
I'll take one.
Or just the one. It's 3 for 2. You know, why not treat yourself?
Oh, Gavin, you've twisted my arm. I'll take 3.
Still got it strong, then. Still got it.
I don't understand. Normally, when you annoy the bakers, they get their own back. Do you remember the time they stabbed Neville?
See, I'm not Neville. They have this thing with me called respect.
There they are, the lovebirds.
Not lovebirds.
Not what it looks like here.
Oh, you look so pretty together. How'd you even get your legs up there?
Wait, that's not us.
Someone's photoshopped our heads on there.
Bakers. Where did you get this?
There's loads of them up all around the store. This one's my personal favourite. It's a bit more tasteful than some of the others.
I've got to say, Daniel, you look exactly like I imagined you would naked.
OK, you do aisles 1 to 8 and I'll do the rest.
What was that thing you said about respect?
Bigger problems, Daniel.
8 sausages, 20 bacon and 1 foot of black pudding.
Cracking.
Oh, well, that'll put lead in your pencil.
I'll need it. Supposed to be going on a dirty weekend with Angelina Jolie.
Oh, everything all right there, Big Len?
Fine. Fine.
No, it doesn't look all right.
I'm fine. It's just my chest.
I think we need to get you some help.
No, it's good. It happens sometimes. I'll just have a lie down.
I think he's having a heart attack.
If he does die, Gav, can we have the day off?
You really should go to hospital. I'm fairly sure you had a heart attack.
It was a turn. I have them all the time.
You need to take better care of yourself.
But it's no wonder. I mean, look at all this processed food and sugars.
It was all on offer.
Yeah, well, you need to have some nutrition too. Look, here's an idea. Why don't you swap these toffee apples for apples?
Apples? Is there any toffee in them?
No.
No chance.
I feel terrible.
Gavin, I'm fine. I've never been fitter. Just ask Beyonce. I was up all night rattling her to death.
No, that's gone too far, Big Len. I mean, banter's one thing, but that was blue.
Sorry, Gavin.
Cheryl?
Gavin, hi.
Big Len, Cheryl, Big Len.
Cheryl?
Big Len.
Cheryl?
Gavin?
What are you doing here? Have you left the iron on again?
Yes, but it's not about that. I was driving to Dudley, I was on the M6 and I was nearly at Stafford Services.
The one with the big Esso?
Yes, I always think it's a big show, but you're right, it is a big Esso.
So is all this detail necessary?
Sorry, I'm babbling, it is just so amazing. Anyway, I got a call and I couldn't wait to tell you the news, so I did a U-turn and I came straight back.
You did a U-turn on the M6?
I know, people were not pleased, but I just had to tell you. They've offered me the area manager job.
Where?
Falco.
Here?
I didn't tell you I'd applied in case I didn't get it, but isn't it great? No more Dudley, we get to see each other more.
Yeah, well, you'll be my boss.
I mean, that's all right, isn't it? I mean, I haven't accepted the job yet. I thought we'd talk it through properly tonight, but isn't it great?
Yeah, it's great.
There we go, sir. Have a lovely day.
Look at those nerves.
Right, I think that's all of them.
Oh, nice on you two. Says it fair dues for managing that. Me and Lisa, we've tried to have a go. I broke my collarbone.
It's not us.
Yeah, I have to say, Daniel, you look exactly how I always imagined you would, naked.
Can everyone stop saying that?
Right, what's everyone getting so worked up about? Yeah, OK, you took a couple of dirty pictures. Me and Lisa, we do that all the time. You should see my camera roll.
Trust me, you really shouldn't.
Katie, Daniel, quick word. As head of security, I can't have you putting these up around the store.
No, it's not us.
Don't get me wrong, they're impressive.
Yeah, not us, guys.
And if we were a supermarket in Germany, they'd be fine. They love their muck over there.
True that.
They really do.
It's like trying to explain to cats, it's not us.
Right, I am shredding these. Daniel, give the radio back to the bakers.
What, and admit defeat?
What?
Quite a fair point.
Daniel, by the way, you look exactly how I've always imagined you to look naked.
It's not enough, Brian.
It's okay.
It's not okay. What's Gavin gonna say when he finds out?
Margaret.
Margaret? You're fired.
Margaret, don't worry, don't worry. We can fix this without Gavin needing to know. We just need to buy a few more scratch cards and I'll win you the money.
But you said scratch cards were a mug's game.
They are, unless you've got a foolproof winning system.
Oh, that's a shame.
No, I was saying that I've got one. It was heavily implied there, Margaret.
Ah, Daniel.
I've given the radio back to the bakers. And a stern warning not to listen to Paul when there are customers around.
Oh, those bakers really are animals.
Any news on the new area manager?
Actually, yes. Head office have offered the job to Cheryl.
Wow. That's great.
Yeah.
You, don't seem pleased.
Daniel, can I be candid with you? On a personal level, you know, man to man.
Yeah, sure.
Obviously, you know, Cheryl's great at her job, but it's a big step up to, you know, be seeing each other at the weekends to, you know, suddenly to be, you know, working, you know, every day with your lover.
Uh-huh.
Well, what if it changes everything? I mean, well, take me and you, right? Like, now, we work because it's professional and not sexual.
What, you don't fancy me?
Oh, no, no, don't mean that, Daniel. No, I mean, you're a very good-looking man and those eyes. No, but, I feel we're getting a bit off message here.
Cheryl being your boss.
Yeah, workplace relationships, you know, they're tricky beasts.
If you find the perfect person, don't let the job get in the way. Sure, you might have said that, you know, you'd just be friends, but, you know, things can change.
Just to clarify, we're not still talking about me and you, are you?
No. Sorry, excuse me, there's something I need to do.
Oh, I knew you and Daniel were doing it.
Proper filthy and all. You know, some of this stuff, even Colin won't do.
That's not us two, all right? Me and Daniel are just friends.
With benefits, sex seekers allowance.
There's nothing going on with me and Daniel.
Come off it, you're all over each other.
Lisa, just shut up. There's nothing going on with me and Daniel. We're friends, we work together. That's all that I want from him. And if that changes, I'll let you know, okay?
Dirtbag.
Not you too, Brian.
Quiet, I need full concentration.
Brian's got a foolproof system, except it's not working.
Guess it's not idiot-proof, then.
Duncan, you're still here.
If by still here you mean on fire, guilty as charged.
Yes, I think you should go.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Keep my powder dry. Come back tomorrow, maybe the day after. Really get a feel for the store over a prolonged period.
Yes, absolutely not what I'm saying.
Of course it's not. I'll see you tomorrow.
Last one.
Oh, I can't watch. I'm so nervous. Oh, please say it's a winner.
One box to go. Yes! It's a winner! £110 exactly!
Oh, Brian! Oh, it worked! Oh, your system worked! I'm going to go and ring Alan and tell him everything's okay. Oh, and I'm going to own up about the mince in the shepherd's pie.
That didn't win.
I know. Couldn't let her down. I better get to the cash machine, get her money out.
You're all right, Gavin. You've been staring at that for ages.
Chocolate fizz.
Yeah, it's nice. Tastes just like chocolate, but fizzy.
Hey, but look at all this stuff we're pushing. Look, sugar butter bites, triple chocolate, muffin, cluster bombs, pizza in a can. You know, it's not very healthy. A customer could have died today.
Yeah, I thought she was stealing. It was a little rugby tackle. She's fine.
What? I'm talking about Big Len. What are you talking about?
Nothing.
Big Len?
Gavin, see, they're still keeping you on.
No, what the hell are you doing back in here? The last thing you should be doing is stocking up with more junk food.
I'm not walk.
Carrots? Low-fat hummus? Apples.
Your wife sent me back in to get some healthier food after what I told her about earlier and what you'd said.
Oh, that's great news. Well done, Big Len.
Aren't you, Torak? I better run. I've got a hot date with a lingerie model tonight.
Oh, Big Len. Oh, you big mad liar. It's really lit a fire under me. I made a morbidly obese man buy carrots voluntarily.
I love it when you get old Jamie Oliver. Say pucker.
No, no, I can't. It's not even a real word. Still, I'd love to push this healthy eating thing. Can you imagine a Warrington full of medium lens and not big lens?
Oh, you know, you should just go for it.
Yeah, I would, but I need permission from my area manager, Cheryl Fairweather.
Really? I thought we were just going to talk about it later.
Oh, what is there to talk about? You should take it. You'll be the best area manager ever.
Oh, I'm just so glad you support me. I did kind of say yes anyway, but it's just good to know that you agree.
Oh, yeah, I'm happy to serve under you.
Getting strong, you saucy bugger.
No, Cheryl, I didn't mean to complicate it with... I mean, I do prefer being below anyway, but...
It's all right, Gavin, it's all right. I'm just pulling your leg. Just breathe.
Don't touch me.
Excuse me.
Yes, I shall be with you in a minute. Right. Can I help you at all, madam?
I've got you something to say, thank you.
Scratch cards.
Well, seeing as your system's foolproof, that's practically money.
Thanks, Margaret.
Let's forget about the restaurant and go straight to the hotel room.
Bloody hell.
Oh!
See you tomorrow.
See you, mate. Bye later.
By later.